call niggas niggas who oppress people for no damn reason. You talk about somebody, you put somebody down, you don't want nobody to like somebody because you don't like them. Nigga, get out of here. Stop oppressing people and hating on people. You try to hold communities down, you try to hold schools down. Look, what the nigga do? Take God out of school? All these school shootings, all these kids done act like they done start serving the damn devil before they get out of 10 years old out of 4th and 5th grade, running around here with guns and killing people. And why? Because the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violent is taking it by force. Just whack, whack, whack. The minute somebody put the seed in you, somebody come along, like the Bible say, and take it out of you, which is Satan, Satan. I'm going to get back to that saint and Satan. So flip the words around. Put an A up in here, honey. Satan. That's what you get. You get Satan. Say you're going to get the Satan. You're going to get Satan out of Saint. You're going to get Satan out of Santa. You just going to get Satan. Satan, period. Talking about the kingdom of heaven. That's what I said. Let me just say this. It's hard to say you're not a Christian. I don't think like Christians think right now. I'm not thinking like you. I'm sorry. There's Yahweh, there's Yeshua, and the Holy Spirit. You keep your God, you keep your Jesus, okay? Your God. There's so many gods out there, and you just want to say, God. What God are you really serving? I could care less at this point. I'm trying to tell you his name is Yahweh. The one of the Bible, his name is Yahweh. Could be her name too, because he created male and female. He created them. So maybe it's a male and female God. I don't know. Their name is Yahweh. They ain't no damn God. No, get specific. Get specific. Get specific. Hell, Satan is a God. Santa is a God. Santa is the God of December. Santa is the God of gift giving. Santa is the God of receiving. Santa is the God of ho, ho, ho. Santa is the God of put your child on my lap. Goddamn strangers, and we doing this shit. Oh, because we so caught up. This is season for, he the season for the reason. And this is the reason so many people get robbed this time of year. So many people get hacked this time of year. So many people get taken advantage of this time of year. But Jesus is the reason for the season. Not everybody believes that. Not everybody believe that. I believed it for a long time. Then I started looking around at the world like, Jesus, if you really the reason for the season, why is it like this around the world? Why? I told you, we gotta stop. I'm gonna stop. Like I said, I'm gonna stop. I know too much, and I'm trying to share it with you. Whether you hear, listen, or not, I'm planting the seed. You could go back and listen to it. I don't care. I'm putting it out here for you because what? I'm being obedient. What? I'm delighting myself in the Lord so that He give me the desires of my heart. Yeah, you have to be the same way. Now, with Christmas, and my biggest point with Christmas is, okay, Pope, whoever over the Gregorian calendar, damn popes again, Gregorian calendar, why couldn't we stick to Yahweh's calendar? Oh, you didn't know New Year's don't start in January. It starts, I think, in September or October, right? Oh, but they'll switch it to confusion. Oh, honey, please. You don't know. You know Jesus loves you. I know you know that. I know he loves you. Zeus do too. Satan do too. Yahweh do too. But he gave you a choice. These people forcing this stuff on you. Forcing you to worship Satan underneath Santa's name. Forcing you to worship other things. That brotherly love stuff I told you was St. Valentine's. We got to find out what kind of brotherly love he was giving out. Because if he was out there giving himself out for brotherly love, then I can understand why there's a lot of gay men in this world. Because St. Valentine gave out brotherly love. According to the book of Romans, they always giving out brotherly love. Now, am I to worship that? Am I to celebrate that every year? Am I to say, okay, I'm okay with that, if that's the real meaning behind it? Nope. Not supposed to say that. Not supposed to do that. Nope. I'm supposed to say, oh, this don't fit my truth. This don't fit my culture. This don't fit my reality. Sorry, I'm not partaking in that. The Bible talked a lot about partaking, and we partake in a lot of stuff that should not be partaken of, Christians. Yeah, we partaking in a lot of stuff that Bible tells us not to partake in. And you rather listen to the Pope, you rather listen to the Greeks, you rather listen to the Romans than you do God. That's why he says, hearken unto me this day, hearken unto my voice, you'll be blessed. We talk about blessed going in, blessed going, blessed. And he said, you'll be cursed. Talk about the powder and the dust that rains, fall down from heaven like rain, afflicting your community. It ain't rise up from hell. God said this gonna come down from heaven and afflict your community. That's that cocaine and heroin and stuff people dying from. Oh, you want to go there? Nope, that's another. It's in Deuteronomy 15. Read from Deuteronomy 28. Start from verse 15. These curses is out here. Why? Because we disobedient, following other gods. Ask God, what is another God? What is another God? What am I doing in my life? Who's the other gods? What's the other God? And start eliminating that stuff. You're still going to be able to enjoy yourself, have festive holidays. And I joke it up with God all day long. I don't know about anybody else, but I be in here cracking up. I know he laughed at me when I said Santa and ho, ho, ho. Why you think Santa don't come to the church and do his picture taking? He don't. He out in the malls hearing it. He getting his glory on too. He getting all the praise and worship. And you let me see. You ever seen a fat white man flying through the air with how many? 2, 4, 6, 8 reindeer? I'll smack you myself and wake you up. You know you ain't never seen it. You're going around talking about, oh, Santa's near Boston. Oh, Santa's near New York. Oh, Santa's over Hawaii. Oh, heck. What the hell is y'all smoking? What we drinking? What is we on? How come we in such a trance to believe this stuff? I don't care. It's real, man. And we, these are things you need to consider. I mean, all that other stuff. These are things, I'm talking religion-wise. Yes, there's a lot of stuff that's going on in the world. Hell, if you break down the religion, you'll understand the world. Because there goes the church, and the rest shall follow. But look, it look like the world leading. So I don't even like saying stuff like that, because I know it's not true. The world ain't leading nothing. The world leading everybody to hell, if we have to say heaven to hell. Because like I said, I'm not the judge. I'm not judging where you're going to go. I'm working my own salvation out with fear and trembling, the Bible says. So I make it in. I'm trying to get myself right. So I'm trying to hear from God so I can help you make it in. You think this thing is guaranteed to us because we said, oh, Jesus is my Lord and Savior. First of all, if Jesus is your Lord and Savior, again, you over in Greece somewhere worshiping Zeus. You better say Yeshua. You better say Yahweh, you better say Christ, say something, because you don't know who you inviting into your heart when you just leave it up to God. There's a lot of gods out there trying to get into your heart. Not all gods is trying to lead you to heaven, though. Especially not this one. Especially not this one. Santa ain't trying to lead you nowhere but jolly. Ho, to that. I'm trying to tell you. I woke up to that. Don't put the kids on a stranger's damn lap. I don't care how jolly, ho, you want to picture. Stand side by side. Hell, you sit on Santa's lap and then put your kid on your lap. How about that? Well, we put our kids in arm's danger all the damn time because of these stupid ass holidays. No. Protect your kid. You barely let your kids.